Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi video. This is Jamie from System 22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we had a great question on one of our videos, and they were asking about the full width slider I've got here and how they can customize these buttons down here, the little sort of pagination buttons. And when I say customize, I don't mean change the color. You can do that within the Divi themselves. I think they wanted to change shape, size, and possibly position. Now, if we go into the builder itself, you can change the colors and everything there, and you can actually do custom CSS for your arrows up here. Let's just go into the builder. And if we go into this module and to the design tab, here's the navigation and here's the dots. You can change the colors and the active color and everything like that right here. Well, you just change the color basically, and the active color is just a different opacity from the regular color. But there's no way of sort of changing the shape or the position. If we go to our advanced to custom CSS, slide title, description, button, controllers, I thought it would go in here. But it doesn't. So we can do this with a bit of custom CSS, and don't let that put you off. It's pretty easy. Okay, let's get started. Let's exit out of here and exit the Visual Builder. Okay, I'm using Google Chrome here with the great inspector tools. Most browsers have this nowadays, but if yours doesn't, Google Chrome is a free download. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to right click on one of these dots to inspect it. And if I pull this up, I will put this code down below the video and you can change it to how you want to do it if you want to, but it's pretty easy. Okay, so it's our active control, or in fact the active control is just our little, let's pull this down just a little bit. Our active control is just the one that's bright there. Let's just get a regular one. There we go. ETPB controllers A is the class name. And you can see we've already got a bunch of entries in here. Let's pull this up a little bit more. So we can start customizing this from here. Color, I'm not going to worry about the color because you can still change that within the module itself. Okay, first things first. If you just want to make them bigger, you've got a width and a height here. Simply put in your new value. Let's make them say 15. And you can get some strange shapes if you do different values like that. They're sort of pill shaped. And if you make the height and the width the same all the time, they will remain round. And you can, I've just selected the number here and I'm rolling up with my mouse wheel just to put it up to 15. There we go, that's made them a lot bigger. If you want to make the space between them more, we've got the margin right here. Let's take that up to 15 also. And that's given them a little more space in between. Okay, well, perhaps you want to make them square, and that's really easy. Just take your border radius away here. And now they're square. And perhaps you might want to make them sort of elongated. Well, easy, just make the width longer. Again, let's just slide it up so they're sort of. Oblongs like that. Now, when we refresh this, this is going to go back to normal. So to make this permanent, we need to write it into our custom CSS. I'm going to show you a couple of other things before we actually do that. Okay, so that's sort of changing shapes and sizes. Now perhaps you might want to have it on the left hand side. If we go in here, so let's create a new entry and make it float, push it over to the left hand side. And to do that, I'm just going to say float colon left. Okay, there's a little bit of space there. You know, I'm not sure you'd want it buffered right up against the left-hand side there. And as you're on the left, What we could do is change this margin from margin right to margin left, and we'd have a bit of space on the left there. As you can see, that's added a bit of space to the left hand side there. And push it to the right, obviously, let's float it right. And again, if you want that space on the right hand side, you don't want it buffered up like that. Just change this again from margin left to margin right. That's created a little problem there. So let's just leave it as it was on left. And what we'd need to do with this is go into the actual active one and just give it a margin on the right hand side. So if we go to the one above, ETPB active, there it is right there. Let's just give it a bit of padding or margin on the right. You'll say margin right, whatever you want, 15 pics. And that's giving it a bit of space that side. But I kind of prefer mine either in the middle or the left. So let's just undo that. That's if you want to do it right. Remember, you've got to do this. And again, you'd have to copy this class name here and this and put it in the custom CSS, which we'll do next. We're not going to do this one because I don't like it on the right hand side there. Okay, so I'm going to let that one go. And we'll go back into our regular ones. Here we go. And here's all the changes we made. Let's put it back on the left hand side, or wherever you happen to want it. There we go, that works for me over on the left hand side. Okay, now let's copy all this. And like I say, if I refresh this, it's all going to go back to how it was. Control C to copy. Let's now get rid of the inspector and refresh the page. And when I refresh, it's going to go back to how it was. As you can see, it's gone back to the little dots there in the middle. So to make this permanent, we need to go over to our customizer. To get to your customizer, go to your dashboard, go down to appearance and customize, or you can go down to Divi theme options and write it in the customizer there. Let's go ahead and do that. Right at the bottom, you'll find the custom CSS box. Let's move these down out of the way. And let's paste that code that we just copied in here. Control V to paste. Now, anything that we didn't change, display, background color, text indent, border radius, we've taken that away there so we can get rid of that. We can get rid of anything that we didn't change or anything that's marked out like that. We changed the float, the width, the height, the margin. We didn't do anything to padding or opacity, so we can get rid of that. Now let's save our changes here. And if we go back to the page and refresh, that should change back to our custom styles that we had just now. There we go. And there they are. Looks like we took the border radius out. Let's go back in there. And we'll say, zero. I may have to add important to that. Once it's saved, let's refresh. There we go, that worked fine. Great. And like I say, to change the colors and everything else, you can go back in and do that within the module itself. Go in there, go to our design tab, navigation, dot nav color, let's change it to black. There you go, or whatever color you might like. There we go. Save this, save the changes. Like I say, you can go to town. It's pretty simple CSS. And to do things with CSS, if you're not sure, just type in what you're trying to do into Google, and there'll be some code there to show you how to do it. But I've covered the basics here today. Let's exit the Visual Builder. And there we have it. So I hope that's answered your question of how to style those. You can do it. You do have to use a bit of code. I'll put this little bit of code down below. Obviously, you can change it, delete the things you don't want, or you can just do it yourself the way I did. So once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.